Want to know what's new for Power BI? This one's special because it drops right alongside Microsoft Ignite. In this video, we're diving into what's new, what's generally available, and what's now in public preview. For all the details, you'll see a QR code on the screen. Scan it to jump straight to the monthly update blog. I'm Adam Saxton. This is the Microsoft Power BI update for November 2025. Let's begin. November is packed with Ignite-level releases that make Power BI more connected, secure, and insight-driven than ever. We're seeing massive strides in Copilot integration, direct lake reliability, and governance enhancements powered by Microsoft Fabric. These updates focus on performance, scalability, collaboration, making Power BI the hub for your business intelligence in your Fabric environment. This month's previews are all about expanding how you build and how you share. We're talking new authoring capabilities directly in the browser, smarter data model management, and some early Copilot experiences that bring generative AI directly into your Power BI workflow. These features are your chance to shape what's coming next. So try them out and tell us what you think. Enough of all my talking, let's see it in action. Here are the demos from the Power BI engineering team showcasing the features that are changing how you build, explore, and gain insights with your data. Let's roll.
In this video, I'll walk through the new features and improvements we've made to the new card visual as it is now generally available. The first improvement I want to show are the new defaults we've updated for the card visual for a modern look and feel. What you see here is the previous default, but to use our new defaults, you can go to the View option in the ribbon, go to Theme, and select the Power BI default theme. And just like that, you are now using our new defaults. All new card visuals that you create after this will also be using the new defaults for a more modern look. The second feature I want to show is the new support for Image Hero. Previously, you could only add an image in the callout area like this. But now we've also added the support for a standalone image hero under the image card. I'm going to select the first trail, turn on image, and expand the data pane. Here, I also see that I have an additional option as well, which is select from data. So if I have a column of image URLs, I can drag that in to be displayed. I also have different styling options as well, such as fit, stretch, fill, and center. And I also have different image effects too that are built in, such as exposure, contrast, saturation, and blur. We've also added new layout options, including a collage layout. By going to the layout group in the cards card, you can now select the collage layout, where the area is split in half and one part is divided into two. I can also choose which one is displayed in which section. Now I can see that the image hero is taking half of the area and the callout and the reference label are splitting the other half.
We're excited to announce the GA of Copilot to write and explain DAX queries in Power BI. So let's create a Power BI semantic model. As announced last month, I can create direct lake semantic models now on the create page using the one lake catalog and quickly add the tables and give it a name and put it in the workspace that I want. Now I'm in the web modeling experience. I can use DAX query view here. And in DAX query view in the web, I have Copilot here to help me. And this Copilot is now GA. Some of the features we have added is quick fill actions. One is to suggest measures for your model. So you take a look at the model that you have and it'll suggest some measures that may be helpful. I can see these, I can run this query, and I can keep it when I'm ready. Not only that, but in DAX query view, once you've created measures in a DAX query, you can actually add these to the model by either using the text above each one of them or using that button at the top to update the model with all of the changes. I can also have it explain DAX topics. So I have a quick action here that I can utilize to quickly bring out an example, or I can ask questions on my own, like what is the difference between sum and sum x? And what's cool, it'll give you examples from the model you're in. Now, it's not only available in the web, it's also available in Power BI Desktop. So let's go ahead and live edit the semantic model in Power BI Desktop. One of the other things, of course, you can do is you can just ask it for any query you want, and it can generate that here in DAX preview. Again, you can run it and keep it. But now I notice that I actually don't want the total quantities delivered here to compare to my target. I need to know the delivery count. And so I can quickly select that, add that change, see everything that changed with a nice div view, run it, and keep this query when I'm ready.
The Power BI Modeling MCP server brings Power BI semantic modeling to your AI agents. The easiest way to get started is opening Visual Studio Code side by side with Power BI Desktop open the GitHub Copilot chat, and ask the agent to connect to the Power BI desktop file I have opened. So in my case, I have a file named sales, so I can just type connect to Power BI desktop sales. And the agent will connect to the semantic model running in the local analysis services instance of Power BI desktop. And when the connection is successful, I can now use natural language and ask the agent to do any semantic modeling change. For example, let's start asking the agent to analyze the current naming convention of my model and make sure that it will follow a consistent and business-friendly one. And we can see the agent going through the metadata of the model, reason about the current naming, and also proposing some changes. Let's tell the agent to go ahead, but also set some personal rules, such as counting measures should include the number sign, measures should be uppercase, and no underscores or technical terms should be used. And we can see the agent applying these changes to the model in Power BI Desktop in real time, just like an external tool would. And just like that, I was able to deeply analyze my model names, identify inconsistencies, and bulk rename everything in seconds using my own custom rules. This MCP server is also capable of connecting to a semantic model in Fabric. All you need to do is ask the agent to connect with the workspace and the semantic model name. And the agent will connect to the semantic model in the Fabric workspace. And of course, because it's in Fabric, it will prompt you to authenticate. And when the connection is done, you can ask the agent to perform any modeling change just like you do in Power BI Desktop. And similar to what we did before, let's open the semantic model in the web side by side with Visual Studio Code and ask the GitHub Copilot to create new measures following an existing pattern of already existing measures. Notice that I don't even need to be exact with the measure names. The agent will now analyze the DAX code of the existing 12-month rolling average, and it will create the two new variations following the same pattern. If I refresh the browser, the two new measures will be there, and I can switch to edit mode and confirm that they are following the same DAX code pattern of the 12-month rolling average. In the previous examples, we worked against live analysis services databases, but the MCP server is also capable of working against offline Power BI projects files. So in this case, I have my PBIP in here, and I have my semantic model represented as Tyndall files. So what I can do now is I can ask the agent to load or connect to this PBIP. This time, we are going to use an inbuilt prompt called connect to Power BI project, and we just need to provide the PBIP path into the parameter. And notice that it's going to create a prompt for me instructing the agent to load the PBIP folder, but it's also going to include the resource file that is in the MCP server that is going to teach the agent how to work with the PBIP, where to read, where to write, and some basic instructions on, for example, what to do when you want to create a new semantic model from scratch. So let's run this. The agent is going to load the Tyndall files from the PBIP folder and load that into an offline Tableau object model instance. And just like before, I can ask to perform any kind of modeling changes. Well, for example, let's ask the agent to set descriptions on all my measures. The agent will go through each measure and analyze its DAX code and generate business-friendly descriptions for each one. And when it's done, it will save the Tyndall back to the PBIP. And because I'm using Git, I can also easily review all the changes that the agent did with Tyndall divs.
The Remote Model Context Protocol server for Power BI includes a set of agentic tools that enables you to chat with your data from your chosen MCP client or agent. Imagine I'm a data analyst at Zava Smart Materials and I want to learn which of my materials my customers prefer. Here I've loaded my semantic model ID into the context of the agent, make sure I'm in agent mode, and then also choose my LLM provider. I'll choose Sonnet 4.5. And now I'm ready to ask my question about which materials have the best feedback. First, the agent retrieves the semantic model schema to understand the context of the semantic model. So we'll see that it passed in the artifact ID or the semantic model ID into the tool, and then it retrieves the schema structure as the output of that tool. Next, it calls the generate query tool, which leverages the same DAX query generation logic as a Power BI Copilot in the standalone experience. The agent formats the input and waits for the DAX query to be returned from Power BI. And now that the agent has the optimized DAX query, it is ready to invoke the execute query tool to get the data and then summarize the results for us. So here we see our top five materials by feedback, all broken down with the sentiment score, the praise rate, and the complaint rate.
The standalone Copilot in Power BI is your go-to space to ask questions about any report, model, or data agent you have access to. Unlike the Copilot pane, which only lets you ask questions about the report you currently have open, the standalone Copilot lets you start broad and ask without specifying what data to use, and will start looking for the right data to provide you with an answer. Copilot searches for items based on their content, how recently you use them, and more. Since the topic of my question was clear, Copilot was able to find the right artifact and tell me that the social media campaign was the most successful. Alternatively, if your question is less specific, like this one, about travel insights, Copilot will work with you to narrow down the topic before generating an answer. In the background, it found some reports about tourism, airports, and hotel bookings, so it's asking a clarifying question to zero in on the right one. Once it's gotten the info it needs from me, it confidently selects the tourism report that contained a verified answer matching my question. If we make another request related to tourism in Hawaii, Copilot will intuitively know to use the same report. But if you know a specific report you'd like to ask about, you can easily attach it. Our updated menu has all item types in one list organized by recency to speed things up. I want to use our data about climbs on Mount Rainier, so I'll just select it here and ask my question. Insights are always within reach.
We are excited to introduce the standalone Copilot in Power BI mobile apps. To start using Copilot, just open the Power BI mobile app and look for the Copilot button on the bottom navigation. Tap the Copilot button in the app and ask a question such as, what is the total spending by island in tourism? Copilot will find a list of relevant items to select from to provide an answer. In the list, I can see that the report I want to use, Tourism Analysis Overview, is also matched as a verified answer. I select the item using the suggestion field. Copilot comes back with an answer. In this case, it provides both a textual answer and a visual. To take a closer look on the data, I tap on the visual. This will open a drawer with a live version of the visual that can be interacted with it. I can also share this visual as a screenshot with colleagues via chat or email. Every response includes an option to copy the response to clipboard, so it can be easily pasted and shared. Next, I will ask Copilot for a summary focused on spending analysis. Copilot generates a summary based on the report, including citation, that opens a drawer displaying the relevant visuals in an interactive graphical view, making it easier to interpret the data. From the drawer, I can open the visual spotlighted directly in the report for deeper analysis. Using the back button will take me directly back to the chat. When using the Power BI mobile app from an iPhone or iPad, it is also possible to dictate a question using the mic in the chat box. For example, show me humidity trend for climb on Rainier. Copilot will find a list of relevant items to select from. After selecting the first option, I notice that Copilot output looks different. Copilot displays a warning to review the answer carefully, since this data hasn't been marked as prepped for use with AI by the model author. I can still view the answer by tapping on View Answer to explore and interact with it. Now, I want to use Copilot to answer a question from a data agent I have in my organization. First, I ask Copilot to find it by saying, find movies analysis data agent. I can see that the data agent I need is numbered 2 in the list. So I ask, use number 2. Which 5 movies have earned the highest gross revenue? The agent responds right within the Power BI mobile app, bringing Fabric data and Power BI together in one seamless mobile experience.
In this video, I'm going to show you the visual enhancements we've made to our image visual. We've also added an entry point in the build pane that's accessible through Surface and Desktop. When I click on it, I see a placeholder, and I'm going to expand the style card and the image group. Under the image source dropdown, I see that I have additional options now, including enter URL and select from data. I'm going to choose Select from Data, and I can drag in a column of image URLs into the field well. I can also make this interactive by adding a button slicer. So depending on the value that I select, the image will change. For example, when I click on Germany, I see an image of the Alps. When I click on USA, I see an image of Mount Rainier. Now back to just the image visual, I also have additional customization options. I can choose the different image fits, such as stretch and fill. I can also make it more transparent as well. And I have additional image effects option, including exposure, contrast, saturation, and blur. I can also add a shape and border around my image as well. I can adjust the roundness of the border too. I can also add a background behind my image. For example, I can add this light blue background. There's also one more addition that we've added, which is the different states that you can customize. We have default, hover, and press. And depending on which state you select, you can add different customizations. For example, if I select hover, I can even select a different image source. For example, if I wanted the helps to always show when it's hover, I can go ahead and paste in an image URL. And when I hover over the image visual, it will show a picture of the Alps.
Ever build a matrix in Power BI only to find your layout looking cramped and unreadable? That's where the new Grow to Fit feature comes in. Here's a matrix visual showing sales by region and product category. Notice how there's all this white space to the right that goes unused. Let's fix that. Select the matrix, go to the format pane, expand column headers, options, make sure that the auto size width is on, and set this to grow to fit. Instantly, the matrix adjusts and the column widths expand to fill the available space.
Here I have my Power BI report that I've published to the web. I can go through each page one by one to see how they're loading, but what I really want is a performance analyzer from Power BI Desktop, so we've added it in. To access Performance Analyzer, first you must be editing the report in the web. Once editing, select View and choose Performance Analyzer. This will open up the same Performance Analyzer pane that you see in Power BI Desktop. And just like in Desktop, click Start Recording, then Refresh Visuals to see all the load times for the visuals on this page. I can expand each one and see a breakdown of each duration and access the DAX query that loaded data into this visual.
We're excited to share both authoring updates and filtering updates for verified answers that lead to better exploration for business users. Let's first take a look at a report that I use that relies heavily on both slicers as well as field parameters. Previously, when you created verified answers, they would inherit any filters that were applied on the visual, but not other things like field parameters, slicer selections, or report interactions like cross-filtering and cross-highlighting. With this new update, you can see here that when I select slicer values or change things like which measure is displayed via my field parameters, I can actually inherit those states into the verified answer definition, and I can see them here reflected in the apply to this visual section. From here, I can do the rest of the setup as normal, creating my trigger phrases either by selecting the suggestions or writing in custom prompts, and of course, select any filter permutations in addition to the ones that are already applied there. Now let's take a look at another verified answer that I want to set up. I'll add my normal trigger phrases using terminology that I know my users leverage, like funnel analysis and things that relate to campaign funnel health. And then of course, I'll go and set up my filter permutations. Now, one thing you'll notice here is that there are several choices here. Previously, I could only select 3, but now I can select up to 10, which drastically increases the flexibility and exploration that I have and can enable for my end users. This is what it looks like for those end users when they go to do their analysis. So I'm going to go ahead and say, show me the funnel health for my B2B and preferred customers who use Bing. Now, this is a combination of a couple different filters that you saw me set up there, but Copilot is going to do its magic and go ahead and apply those accurately with 2 filters applied to customer type and 1 to traffic source.
Wow, those were some amazing demos. What are you most excited about? What else do you want to see? Drop them in the comments below. We'd love to hear what you think. For all the details, scan that QR code on the screen or hit the link in the description below to check out the monthly update blog. And don't forget to join the Microsoft Fabric community to connect, learn, and share your own Fabric journey and Power BI journey. Thanks for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.